Well, good morning. You ever hear that saying, careful what you wish for? That's exactly what today is all about. The last couple of days we've been, well, I wouldn't say praying, actively seeking perhaps a break in the weather, because it was cold. It was damn near minus 20. So we got our break in the weather. It's much warmer today. It's only minus one or two, I think, right now. Much, much warmer. But it is snowing to beat the band. So plans changed today. I'd originally intended to do a farm tour at the behest of a family member. We were gonna go all four corners of the farm and then use the house as a landmark. Say, okay, this is how far it is from this corner to the house. The sheep obviously want to participate in that too. Anyways, it looks like a farm tour is off the books today, just simply because, you know, if we get down to the far bottom of the farm, we probably won't even be able to see the house today because it'd be just a blanket of white snow. So I guess to make it up to you, here's a few moments of interpretive dance from Charlotte. Well, if that wasn't the cutest thing you've ever seen, I don't know what is. Anyways, we can't dance the day away. We've got chores to do, so we got all our buckets loaded up. We're going to go feed the sheep, the chickens, the horses, the pigs, the whole menagerie. So let's go. Gave the piggies their slop in their big tub there. And also topped up this bulk feeder. It's got enough dry feed in it for probably 3-4 days. So just fork some hay over to the ewes. On average, the ewe's gonna require about 4 to 5 pounds of hay a day. Usually try to decide on about the 5 pounds because sheep are renowned for being like food wasters. Anyway, Charlotte and I are gonna take the side-by-side back to the shop. We're gonna go get a bucket of chicken feed. And then while we're in there feeding the chickens, I think we're gonna wire in that light so we can see there in the morning. All right, well, Charlotte and I just came back from what was somewhat of an unexpected adventure. We just sat down to lunch, made some soup, we sat down for lunch, and I can see out the window, there's a pickup by our southwest field, right by the gates. And so I get the binoculars out and I thought, well, what's this person doing? And lo and behold, flings the gates open. And I thought, well, you know, there's a well in there, but there's really nobody has any business in there. Anyways, the guy hops in his truck and drives away. The gates are wide open. And I can see there's a moose running down the field. And I thought, boy, that sure is strange. So then I grab Charlotte and I hop in the pickup and I go and I meet him down the corner. And I said, did you just open the gate? And he said, yeah, there was a moose. And so for those of you that maybe you don't have a moose in your area, you don't know what a moose is like, it's like a horse, but it's like the ugliest horse you've ever seen. And then they have antlers, but not like deer antlers. They have like basically boat paddles for antlers. They just lumber around, but they're like 17, 18 hands high. Like their legs are as long as a man is tall, and it's in the field. And if you go any, you know, field in Northern Alberta on, you know, in October, you're probably going to see, you know, especially close to a wetland where we live right on the edge of a lake. So there's moose around and they're in the field. It's a perfectly normal, natural thing. So anyways, this gentleman said, yeah, there was a moose and he wouldn't come out of the field. So I opened the gate. Well, you know, we've got cows in here. So just word of the wise, don't open a farmer's gates, especially when there's cows in there, and then just drive away. If you're concerned that there's wildlife in the field and you're concerned for their well-being, come and talk to the landowner. We'll deal with it. In this particular case, there's a moose here every year. They quite frequent this area, especially with the natural wetland in the area. So yeah, he'll be fine. Just leave him. He got over the fence. If he wants back out, he'll get back over the fence the way he came in or find an alternate means, but don't open the gates. Okay, so I'm back in the chicken coop. I got wire strung all the way from the electrical outlet along the wall to the switch, up and over, and to the light. As you can see, everything works. That's fantastic.
Early mornings will never be the same.
All right, so our friendly amendment to the lighting is done with this little bit of a guard over here. This is going to prevent the chickens from landing directly on the light bulb or pooping on the light bulb and just creating an electrical or a fire hazard. As well as it gives them this kind of cool little launch pad slash diving board that they can jump off of into the rest of the coop. So we'll call that project a wrap. I'll go inside and fetch a cup of tea. All right, well, I got the cup of tea fixed up. I'm just over here whipping up some pierogies and some chicken. So I'll let you go for now. Hope you have a fantastic evening. We'll see you tomorrow.